Hey everybody, this is the Beware reading for your sign for this month. I'll do three spreads. What you need to be aware of this month spread, the advice spread, and the next good thing that'll happen to you this month that'll at least put a smile on your face spread. Please like, share, and subscribe. Let's begin. Hi Taurus, this is the Beware spread. We have the Hierophant, we have the Knight of Cups, we have the Hanged Man clarified by Judgment, we have the Two of Swords clarified by the Four of Swords and Death, and we have the Queen of Swords on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with another Taurus or a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces. You could be dealing with an air sign, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. So it's one of those spreads where it could go either way, and by that I mean it could be you reaching out to somebody with a love offer, or it could be the other way around, they could be reaching out to you. So the Hierophant, the first card I came out, is either another Taurus you're dealing with, but most likely this is you, Taurus. This is your card. Then we have the Knight of Cups. It could be a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces you're dealing with, or this is the love offer that's on the table here, and it could be your love offer, or it could be a love offer coming towards you. And the Knight of Cups usually means that the person making the offers got genuine, authentic, loving emotions, right? But then we have the Hangman clarified by Judgment. The Hangman is a situation that is stuck, so perhaps if you reach out to somebody, they'll put you on hold for the unforeseeable future, right? They'll need some time to think about it, or perhaps they're dealing with other people. Judgment could be somebody from the past. So you could be reaching out to an ex, or an ex could be reaching out to you. Or judgment is all about making the judgment call, right? If this is a new connection, then the person you are dealing with or you will have to take some time off and think about it. And that's exactly what I see in the outcome. But unfortunately, the outcome is negative. But we'll get to that in just a second. We have the Queen of Swords on the bottom of the deck. It could be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius you're dealing with. Or this person is very decisive, and this person is ready to cut somebody out of their life. By the way, male or female, for the Queen of Swords, doesn't matter. You could be embracing the energy of the Queen of Swords. Somebody who is seeing it all, somebody who can smell bullshit from a mile away. But like I said, the Queen of Swords is somebody who is ready to cut somebody out of their life. And like I said, in the outcome, we have the Two of Swords clarified by the Four of Swords and Death. So the answer is going to be no with the Two of Swords and Death. You could be dealing with a Scorpio, because Death is the personal Scorpio card. But with the Two of Swords, is still, in this particular spread, is a big no. Somebody's closed off. Somebody's decision will be no, and it could be yours or it could be theirs. And the Four of Swords is very similar to the Hangman energy. Somebody's going to need some time off to think it through, right? So yeah, let's take a look at the second spread. The second spread is the advice. Here's the advice for you, Taurus. This is from your perspective. This is what you need to do, or at least take into consideration. We have the Two of Cups, we have the Page of Pentacles, then we have the Eight of Swords clarified by the Nine of Swords, and we have the Four of Pentacles and the Nine of Wands on the bottom of the deck. I couldn't help it. I looked underneath the Four of Pentacles, and we've got the Nine of Wands there. So if you're the one making or thinking about making an offer of love to somebody, then don't. Unfortunately, it's going to be rejected, and it will only give you anxiety, depression, and it will make you feel really sad. If they are the ones reaching out to you, then this is the advice for them, because they are wasting their time. I think Taurus is not going to be very receptive here for one reason or the other. So the first card that came out is the Two of Cups. It's actually a really good card. Two of Cups is a card of a soulmate. This is when two people are on the same page, and this is what the person making the offer is hoping for, I guess. And then we have the Page of Pentacles. This is the offer, and whenever I see the Page of Pentacles, this is somebody who is serious, somebody who is looking for long term. The Page of Pentacles could be something tangible, something you can touch. It could be a gift. But then in the outcome, we have the Eight of Swords clarified by the Nine of Swords. So those two cards are not very positive by themselves, and especially together. This is a card of somebody who is stressed out, somebody who's got anxiety and panic attacks, somebody who stays up at night thinking about it. On the bottom of the deck, we have the Four of Pentacles. This is somebody who is closed off emotionally. And the Nine of Wands is the card of a wounded warrior, somebody who puts up a wall between themselves and the other person. So the advice here is clear. Don't bother. It's not going to go anywhere, unfortunately. All right, so we're moving on to the third spread. The third spread is all about the next good thing that will happen to you. All right, Taurus, so here's the third spread. This is all about the next good positive thing that will happen to you that will at least put a smile on your face. Spread. We have the Ace of Cups. We have the Knight of Cups. We have the Three of Wands, clarified by the King of Wands in Strength. And we have the Five of Cups, clarified by the Three of Swords with the Six of Swords. You could be dealing with a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces. Or you could be dealing with a fire sign, Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. So it kind of looks like you could still give this a chance. I'm talking about what we saw in the first two spreads. And you will get rejected. Or if somebody reaches out to you, they will get rejected. Perhaps it could have been an ex, and you don't want to have anything to do with that ex. Or you had a breakup, you went through something very devastating in the recent past, and that's why you didn't want to deal with that first person. However, there will be another person, right? A new person coming towards you. Most likely this King of Wands right there. It could be a fire sign, Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Or this person is very fiery, very passionate, and they'll be able to help you out of that shithole that you could be in right now. Or that X could be reminding you of. And you'll be moving on, moving out of that. So the first card that came out is the Ace of Cups. This is one of the best cards when it comes to love offers. Then we have the Knight of Cups. The Knight of Cups is very symbolic because it came out right next to the Ace of Cups. The Knight of Cups is holding up a cup, and I think that's exactly the cup we see in the Ace of Cups. That's where the symbolism is. The Knight of Cups could be a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces, or this is the love offer. Very genuine, very authentic, and very emotional, because two cup cards are right there in a row. Very emotional. This person is going to be madly in love with you. And then we have the Three of Wands, clarified by the King of Wands and Strength. It could be a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, or it's a lot of passion with this person. A lot of passion. All wands right there, right? Strength could be a Leo you're dealing with, or strength is raw, pure passion. The Three of Wands is somebody who's made up their mind, most likely you, Taurus, to move forward with this King of Wands. And in the outcome, we have the Five of Cups, clarified by the Three of Swords and the Six of Wands. The Five of Cups is a card of a regret, or this is a card of grieving, thinking about the past, leaving in the past. And the Three of Swords right there, it symbolizes what actually happened in the past. This is some kind of a breakup or devastation. And the Six of Swords right there, this is you moving out of that energy with the help of this new person. The Six of Swords is often called the rough patch being over, and that's exactly what I see happening here. The rough patch of your life is coming to an end again with the help of this new person who is going to be very passionate and at the same time very loving about you. So yeah, love and passion kind of balancing out. All right, so that's what I got for you, Taurus. I'm not sure what you are going through or what that person we saw in the first two spreads has done to you, or why they don't resonate with you. Perhaps this is an ex. But either way, that person is definitely not going to be a part of your life anymore. However, this new person will be a part of your life, and this person will help you out and make you feel really, really good. They'll make you feel loved again. And there you have it. I hope my readings resonated with you, and if they did, I hope they make your lives better in one way or the other. Please share and subscribe and hit the bell to get notified. Thank you for watching.